वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन प्लांट्स. सो बेसिकली वी हैव डिस्कस द प्लांट रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट, प्लांट रिप्रोडक्शंस. सो इन प्लांट रिप्रोडक्शंस टू मेथड्स इज देयर फॉर रिप्रोडक्शंस. वन इज एसेक्सुअल, अनदर इज सेक्सुअल. सो टुडे आई विल डिस्कस द दिस पार्ट, दैट इज योर सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शंस. सो एक्चुअली इन नेचर द सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शंस ऑकर इन प्लांट्स एज वेल एज इन एनिमल्स. So it is the most common method for reproductions. Okay. So as you know, in case of reproductions, two gametes is required. One is male gamete, another is a female gamete. So when this female gamete and the male gametes are fused together, and it will form the new cells or the new new daughter cells. So this actually the new cells, that actually is your fused product by the combinations of the two reproductive organs, that is your female reproductive organs, or you can say the female gamete, or you can or the male gametes. That means the female cell and male cell, these two gametes or these two cells, when fused together, it will call fertilizations. So this fertilizations process we'll discuss in this unit. Okay. So in class 7 we have learned this one diagram of flower, that is a part of the flower, and that time we have learned the process of the process or the methods. So this again we will discuss this point, that is the pollination point. So the process actually carried out in case of flower before going to the main topic. So I will just focus on the some few points that is most essential for the reproductions. First of all, this flower having the various part. So your concept clarity, so you need to learn first these things. So this part actually is called petals, and this is the very bright part of the plant. And this part actually is your ovary, and here some ovule is present, and this part actually is your anther part, and this part actually your anther part, and this anther part is related with one filament, and this part, that is your stigma, it is related with a style. Okay, so these are the whole things. As we know from the previous class, it is a complete flower having the four parts. Okay, so androecium, gynoecium, calyx and corolla, these are the four parts. Okay, and from these four parts, the one part, that is your gynoecium part, this part actually your female reproductive part, and your androecium part, that is your male reproductive part. In case of androecium, so this androecium basically contain the pollen grains, and it having the anther, and this anther produce the pollen grains, and after the pollen grains is come from this anther part to the stigma, and thereafter the pollination will takes place. So these are the things we will discuss in this lesson. So first of all, why we do need the sexual reproductions? So sexual reproductions bring about a fusion of the gametes from both the parents. Okay, the zygote, that means the first cell, so formed, thus the positive characteristics of the both parents. This is also helps to bring the variations among the new individuals. Okay, so that means you can know the understand why children of the same parents show the variations. Okay, so these are the things you have to learn. So this in case of sexual reproductions of the plant, there are the four parts, that is again that is a full holder, that is calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium is expert. The first, that is we will discuss one by one. This is the part, that is your filamentary part, and this filamentary part having the anther part, and this is called the stamen. Okay, and again the carpel part, this carpel part actually contain the female, that is your gynoecium part. Basically it contain the stigma, and this stigma is connected to the style, and again the style will connected this ovary part, and ovary is related with this ovule, and where here actually the fertilization actually takes place. Okay, so these are the diagram of the female gamete inside the ovule. So these are the eggs, and this is the whole gamete of the female gamete, or you can say the ovary. And in this ovary, the one part is there that is called ovule, and this ovule is consist of the eggs. Okay, and here the fertilization is takes place. So now I will discuss the summary of the of a bisexual flower, means the one whereas the two gamete is present, one is female and another is male. So first of all, that is sepal. So this is the sepal part. Actually the first function is to protect the essential parts during the birth stage, and number two, to manufacture the food due to the presence of the chlorophyll. So this is the main or major functions of the sepal. Okay, now coming to the point, that is your petal. Petal basically the bright part, and this bright part actually attracted by the insects. Okay, if the an insects will not attracted particularly in this petal part, so the pollination will not occur satisfactorily. Okay, the third, that is your stamen, and stamen basically your androecium part, and this androecium part consisting some anther and as well as the filament, and this produce the pollen grains within which the male gametes will developed, and from there this is the anther part, and where the pollen grains is formed or produced, and after the point, that is your stamen, that is your carpel, and this carpel the function, there is a three part is there. There is a female reproductive organs, and this female reproductive organs, that is your stigma, style and ovary, and stigma basically receives the pollen grains, and whatever the amount of the pollen grain has been deposited in stigma, that that is called actually, whereas the container, you can say that the suppose one container whereas the all the pollen grains has been deposited, that is actually stigma of the female part, and this stigma is connected with a one duct, that is actually your style, and this style actually connected the whole pollen grains from the stigma to the ovary, and this ovary contains the ovule, and which actually produce the female gametes, and whenever in this process is being carried out, whenever the all the pollen grains in come into the contact with stigma, and after the whenever the all the pollen grains is collected or deposited in stigma, and after that the style carried the whole pollen grains to the ovary, and ovary contains the ovule where the eggs is present, and that time the pollen grains will be fused together with the ovules or eggs, and that time the fertilization is takes place. Okay, now coming to the point, that is your pollination. So pollination basically is the transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma. So it can be possibly it can be transferred to the same flower of an or the another flower or same species. So the transfer of the pollen grains to the stigma can be takes place in two ways. So one way is, that is your cell pollination, another is your cross pollination. So cell pollination basically the transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma of the same flower. Suppose that this is the diagram. Suppose that this is a plant, and this plant contain the two flowers, and the same plant contain the two flowers. When the pollen grains is transformed from into between these two same flower, that is actually is your cell pollinations. Okay, so the pollinations basically